You see that guy? He's a sheriff. He doesn't like black people. He was recorded calling them the black B word, all right? Let's go ahead and go to the first recording. This is the sheriff out of North Carolina, Columbus County. Here's the sheriff talking.
It's gonna be a new fucking day. I'm still the mother sheriff, and when I'll go there and fire my goddamn f***ing black bodies. That's like, I'm scared. That's stupid. I don't know what else to do with it. So it's just time to clean them out. There's a snitch in there somewhere telling what we're doing, and I'm not gonna have it. I'm not gonna have it.
So all thing I'm gonna do is pull phone records
and start checking.
I ain't putting trackers on people, but phone records tell the deal. Yep. So just give them a heads up. Hell's coming, I promise. So as I find out who it is, they ain't gonna lie. You and Aaron put your heads together tomorrow and see if y'all can figure out who it is.
Alright. Have you talked to him?
Nah, I ain't talked to him.
Okay.
Have not. Not all day long. I'm gonna call him as soon as I get up on what you do.
Right.
But I've already called Verizon. That guy's gonna give me the records, and we're gonna go through them. Melvin Campbell, Lewis, Hatcher, they fired. They're gonna be guilty by fucking association. You agree?
We don't need no snake, bro.
I ain't gonna have it. I'm gonna cut the snake's head off. Period. And Melvin Campbell's the biggest snake as little stature ever dared to be. Every black that I know, you need to fire him to start with. He's a snake.
The sheriff went on to say, I'm sick of these black bastards, is what he said. Now, you know, the person recording him was actually a white man that he trusted. Okay, I got more video, I got more recording, here it is.
What are they trying to say?
It's just all the time. But from 2 weeks ago, when I got rid of Melvin leaving up till now, when I see Melvin Campbell has called anybody, or anybody's called him, they're gone. Same with Lewis Hatcher. And it's Sabrina, whoever, they're gone. And I'm telling you, this is as far as I can be. Just giving you a heads up, that's coming. When me and Boyd and Nancy go through it tomorrow, the first numbers we see,
The sheriff said they ain't gonna make it, brother. Put up his picture full of mass here. I got some work to do. You see that sheriff? He thought black people were out to get him. That's what he said. He called them snitches, snakes, and bastards. He also said if any person called a particular individual, talking about his political opponent, he was going to check their phone records and it would not be good for them. He said, and I quote, as soon as I find out, it ain't gonna be good. Now, the person who was recording him was his own captain. While he's so damn paranoid about what black people would do, it was his captain recording him as he confided into his white confidant. Let's put up the picture of Jason Souls. But look at that. Jason is now running for sheriff against the same guy he recorded. I'll be damned. Columbus County, North Carolina. On one end of the phone was the Columbus County Sheriff, Jody Greene. On the other end was then Captain Jason Souls, who had just been tapped to lead the sheriff's office while elections officials investigated a complaint questioning if Greene was eligible to even serve as sheriff. Now I'm going to highlight some elements connected to his campaign where he may not even be the proper elected sheriff. Greene wanted to know who in the sheriff's department had communicated with Lewis Hatcher. Remember that name? Lewis Hatcher is the former sheriff whom Greene narrowly defeated. When I say narrowly, like 30 votes, okay? He narrowly defeated Greene in the election. And Melvin Campbell, a recently fired sergeant, both of whom are African American. In Greene's words, they had a snitch in the office. No, you had a snitch talking to you, sir. But he says, no, there's a snitch in the office leaking information to his political opponent who had sued to be reinstated until the election protests were resolved. I'm sick of it. I'm sick of these black bastards, said Greene to Souls. I'm going to clean house and be done with it, and we'll start from there. The call between Greene and Souls took place about 2 months into what was a difficult start to Greene's career as a sheriff. Greene beat Hatcher in 2018 by just 34 votes at that time. When election fraud in this rural part of North Carolina was making national headlines, the results were protested. In part over concerns, Greene did not actually live in Columbus County as required by state law. He'd also been improperly sworn in before the state certified the election results. He made them swear him in before the election results were certified because he knew good and damn well perhaps this could go in the other direction once they investigated his actual residential requirement. There's more. Souls, the captain who recorded him, who is now running for sheriff himself, said he was concerned, that he was very concerned that the most powerful law enforcement officer in Columbus County was racist and would not treat black people or black employees or the residents he policed fairly. The call happened late one night in early February 2019, trying to track down the source of the apparent leak in his office. Greene can be heard saying that he's contacted Verizon to get phone records to see if anyone in his department had made calls or received calls from Lewis Hatcher or Melvin Campbell in the last 2 months. Souls also told WECT, the local affiliate there, that immediately after his appointment, was acting as acting sheriff, he began getting late night phone calls from Greene. So Greene calls the captain who's basically serving as the sheriff interim while they resolve the election issue. So he's calling the sheriff who's acting in the position to complain about the black people around him. Late night phone calls. He said, and I quote, this one particular phone call that I received, he made the comment that he hated Democrats. And then he said, I hate that black, I hate that, I hate a black effing Democrat. And I knew right then, I was like, wow, this is coming from the sheriff. And I had to start recording those conversations. So said of the moments before he hit record on his phone. Since taking office, what has this sheriff done? Because I know some people will push back and say, well, Doc, did he lead in a way that was adversarial to those in command, to individuals in that community, to people he worked with? Yes, he did. He led in a racist way, just like his phone call illustrates. Since taking office, Sheriff Jody Greene has made some significant changes to his staff. When Sheriff Hatcher was in charge, there were two African Americans on his command staff, Lieutenant Jeremy Barber and a captain named Clementine Thompson. Greene decided to demote Thompson within days of taking office and cut her pay by $10,000. She was later fired. Barber, formerly the department's lead detective, was demoted to the civil division. Greene's command staff, made up of his highest ranking officers, no longer has any minorities whatsoever. 100% white. Okay. Now, this is the reason why a lot of people don't like the police. Now, why did this recording come out? This recording came out because there was an attempt by Captain Souls and others to actually go through the normative channels, sound the alarm internally with members of justice in that local community, and none of them did a damn thing. Because of the inaction of other members of justice who should have launched an official investigation into the sheriff, because of their inaction, Souls and others made a decision to expose the nature of these recordings. I actually believe more recordings exist, to be frank with you, but we will continue to follow this story as it develops. Yasmin, you know the deal here. You have a racist chief executive in law enforcement governing in a way that's contrary to the progress and protection of the local community. What are your thoughts?
Yeah, it's really sad to continually see stories like this, even after what this country's been through as far as race relations. And I'm not even necessarily talking about slavery or Jim Crow or the civil rights movement. I'm just talking about the last few years. I feel like people like you, Dr. Richey, are making the best effort to publicize and call attention to these people and to the systems that support and uphold them and protect them. But even with all of that national and even international attention, people like Sheriff Greene still exist. They're still employed as public servants and they are still unapologetic. You know, racism is a deeply held delusion held amongst deeply ignorant and simple-minded people. But we need to keep fighting against people like this, or at the very least, just keep them out of positions of power. And shout out to the white ally who played the long game, built a case against this guy and then dropped the evidence. Thank you.
Literally, his own racism brought him down. He believed that every black person was out to get him. And obviously he believed that these white people around him were for him. He thought they thought like him. He was wrong.